In this video, we will talk about methods to modify the rate of absorption. Let's get started. Depending on the requirement, we might want to control the rate of drug absorption. For example, if we want prolonged action, we want to slow down the absorption. And if we want quick action, we want the absorption to be very fast. Methods by which we can do so are slow-release dosage forms, enteric-coated tablets, changing physical characteristics of the drug, adding vasoconstrictor, or applying a tourniquet, adding hyaluronidase to the injection, rubbing, and massage. Now let's talk about each method in more detail. First, slow-release dosage forms. They include retard tablets, spansules, depot injections, and subcutaneous implants. As per the name, they release the drug slowly. So absorption is slowed, and prolonged action can be obtained. Next, enteric-coated tablets. In the previous video, we saw that gastric acid destroys certain drugs, and therefore, certain drugs are not effective when given orally. Enteric-coated tablets are the solution to this problem. In such tablets, there is an outer coating on the tablet. It prevents the degradation of the drug from gastric acid when it is in the stomach. In the intestine, this coating gets dissolved, and the drug from the inner core is absorbed. In this way, we can give acid-labeled drugs by oral route. So this was about enteric-coated tablets. Next method is changing the physical characteristics of the drug. For example, insulin-zinc suspension. There are two such suspensions. One is ultralent. In this, large crystalline particles are formed, which are insoluble in water. It releases insulin slowly. So absorption, and therefore action, is prolonged. The other form is semilenti. In this, smaller, amorphous particles are formed. It releases insulin fast. So absorption is fast, and action is rapid. The next method is adding a vasoconstrictor, or applying a tourniquet. In the video on factors affecting drug absorption, we have seen that decreased blood flow decreases absorption. So if we want to decrease absorption, one way to do so is to decrease blood flow where the drug is administered. Methods for this are adding a vasoconstrictor drug or applying a tourniquet. For example, local anesthetics are often combined with vasoconstrictors, like noradrenaline or adrenaline. Vasoconstriction caused by them decreases local blood flow. So absorption of anesthetic into the systemic circulation is decreased. This prolongs the local action of the anesthetic and also decreases systemic toxicity. So this was about decreasing blood flow. Now the next factor. It is adding hyaluronidase to the injection. Hyaluronidase is an enzyme that breaks down the matrix. This promotes the spread of the drug, which in turn increases absorption. Next, rubbing increases absorption from the skin. And finally, massage. It increases blood flow and therefore increases absorption. So these were all the factors affecting absorption. Now let's have a quick summary. Slow-release preparations slow down the absorption. Enteric-coated tablets prevent the degradation of drugs by gastric acid. By changing the physical characteristics of the drug, we can control the rate of absorption. Vasoconstrictor drugs and tourniquet help decrease absorption by decreasing blood flow. Hyaluronidase increases absorption by promoting the spread of the drug. Rubbing and massage also increase absorption. That's it for this video. You can find notes and explore our entire animation video library on our website. The links are in the description. If you liked this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. And don't forget to subscribe, because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.